Well, good morning. It's December 12th, and it's a windy day in the neighborhood.
Hey, are you one of those people that just can't seem to stay warm when you're hunting? Now, do you avoid the tree stand when the temperatures dip below freezing? Now, probably you've tried those expensive parka systems with the insulated bibs and everything, and only to find that you're losing all your body heat through all the gaps and seams and zippers and whatever and the pieces of the system. Now, maybe you have the warm clothing and it does keep you warm, but you find when you put it on, you really can't move around like you don't have the mobility that you need to perform at your best, to draw your bow, to raise your gun, to hike in. And if you do hike in with this stuff on, by the time you get to your stand, you're sweating so bad your base layers are soaked, which renders the parka system almost useless, and you're going to get cold. Not to mention the fact that you've now permeated the woods with your scent. Now, our blustery Octobers, November rains, December blizzards, January ice storms, the reason you stay on your couch and your season is shortened. Well, check out how I beat the cold in this edition of iHunt TV's Tips, Tricks, and Gear Reviews. Now, I love to bow hunt. Now, I can't seem to get enough of it, but our season in Missouri runs from September 15th to January 15th. Needless to say, there's a vast array of weather conditions that can occur between those two dates, from everything from extreme highs like in the summertime, 80s, 90s, upper 90s, to frigid cold in deep winter. And throughout that time period, you can also see a vast array of changing weather conditions, whether it's a light rain, a heavy rain, snow, ice, wind, all of those things come into play. Missouri is also notorious for weather conditions that change on a dime, so you have to be ready for any of that. But I found when the extreme weather hit, in the late season especially, I lost my motivation to get off the couch and get out to my deer stand. But when I did go out, I could only stay out there for maybe an hour or two before I froze out. Now, if a light rain blew through in December, forget about it, because once you got wet, you got cold, and I just couldn't stay out there. So after a while, I wanted to hunt, and I started to play the layer game. So I put more and more layers on as the weather got cold. I ended up packing more gear in, and I found that I could get myself to a point where I could stand the elements. But when it came time to draw my bow, I was like the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man with a compound bow out there. I just couldn't draw and hold on target accurately. I also found that when I was walking in these layers, it was very difficult. So mobility was one of the things that I needed to close the deal in a late season hunt when the weather turned bad. So the layer game really wasn't working for me. Now, there are several cold weather systems on the market today, and some very good ones, and they're all designed to do one thing. They're designed to keep you warm. So I was looking for a garment that was versatile. Obviously, I wanted to be able to use it for in different scenarios and situations. I was looking for something, obviously, that would keep me warm, but also provide me with the mobility that I needed if I wanted to do a run-and-gun style hunt, but also that affords me the protection from the various elements that I might experience, whether it's rain, snow, wind, whatever, extreme cold, if I wanted to sit all day. And now it's hard to find something that meets all of those criteria, but that's when I discovered IWOM outerwear, and especially the IWOM XT. Well, as I mentioned in this opening segment, my research led me to a company called IWOM Outerwear. Now, the name IWOM was kind of intriguing to me because I didn't know what it meant. And then I learned it stands for Inner Warmth, Outer Mobility, which are two of the things that I was really looking for in a cold weather system. Something that was versatile, something that I could move in, and something that kept me warm. So I found that in this suit. I have two IWOM suits here. This is the first one that I bought, and let me say this before we get started at unpacking this suit. I pro staff for several companies. IWOM was my first company that I pro staffed for, and I bought this suit before I was a pro staff member. Now, all of the systems that I use, all the different companies that I pro staff for, Scent Crusher, Luminoc, Tacticam, Black Widow Deer Lures, and IWOM, I use their products, and I use them as a regular person, not on their pro staff. I didn't get on their pro staff to get their products. I tried it. I will not pro staff for a company that I don't believe in. But I have two IWOM suits. This is the very first one that I bought. It's a real tree HD AP, and they make different camo patterns. You can see this is the Predator camo that I bought prior to my elk hunting trip in Colorado. So I packed this up a mountain. So you can see that the suit rolls up in itself. And so it weighs about the same as other garments do. If you figure parka system with the bibs and the coat and the inner coat and all that stuff that they have, it weighs about the same amount. So you're packing about the same load. However, this one rolls up in itself and has a fanny pack strap. So if I'm packing in, you just latch it on and you got your fanny pack mode here that you can do it. This suit is very versatile and it's very warm. So let's unpack this thing and show you what it does. As you can, as I mentioned, it rolls up in itself. There's a kind of a stretchy pocket here that allows you to pack everything in. So to unroll it, you simply just pull it out. And the way I'm going to talk about this suit is I'm just going to roll it out here on the floor and work from top to bottom. So here I am. This suit has a rain hood with a nice bill on it, and it's got all kinds of Velcro enclosures. If you look in the back, there's a padded thing here with a Velcro enclosure. But if I've got my hand, let's see if I can get my hand inside the suit. Hands inside the suit, and you can see right here, my fingers out. That's where your tree strap for your harness. So you put your harness on underneath it, and your tether strap comes out to hook into the tree. We got our rain hood with various drawstrings on it to tighten it up around your head. It has a full face mask, deployable face mask. This heavy duty zipper, it's a 3/4 zipper that goes down the front, is a waterproof zipper. All of the seams in this are waterproof tape, and this suit is waterproof. I can literally sit in rain, and I have, and not gotten wet on the inside. So all the zippers are heavy-duty zippers, waterproof. As you move down the suit, there's two pockets right here. So basically right in here, I'll put the suit on here in a second, that have zippers on the outside. Again, waterproof zippers. Nice pull tabs on them. And you can, you know, there's little hand pockets on each side. In the front, it has this kangaroo style hand warmer pocket, which is really great in the stand. I throw a couple hand warmers in there, and I can basically run with no gloves. I have this giant kangaroo pouch pocket here, which is very roomy. It's very deep. You can drop binoculars in here, that type of thing. On the side, on each side, there's a pocket, or a pass-through, I call it a pass-through pocket. This pass-through pocket has a pocket sewn in there, so it will actually hold something inside the suit, but it also has a snap enclosure in the inside. You have a zipper to keep air from escaping if you want, but you also can get inside and get into your pants pockets if you need to adjust or whatever. Eat one on each side. And then, this is the, on the very front, kind of the front right, there's this slit here. And the only thing I can think that this is a relief port. So, if you're in your tree and you're fully deployed in the suit and you need to go to the bathroom, there you go. You can take care of it. And then, as you go down, of course, around the base, this is a belt. It's actually a waist belt, even though it's down around your feet. And then the foot compartment is here. So let me show you how easy this is to get in. Now, when you pack in, you can pack it in a fanny pack mode, get to the base of your tree. deploy the suit. I'm seated right now, but just to try to stay in frame. But I might be standing up when I do this. So you get your feet out. The inside in the bottom is a waterproof covering on there. So if you got muddy boots or something like that, you can just wipe it out. These things are machine washable. You're in your suit. You can tether your strap, your tree stand strap through there. Grab it, pull it out. If you're hunting from a tree, ground blinds, this is a piece of cake. So your wrist gaiters, hands are in if you want them. Now I shoot a caliper release. So I don't use the wrist gaiter on this side when I'm bow hunting. I just tuck it back up in. Each sleeve has a Velcro strap, which you can tighten up and to keep that sleeve out of the way. Keep the seam tight or the gap tight so you're not losing warm air out of there. So this is deployed mode. IWOM makes another suit called the Stalker, which doesn't have the foot compartment in. The XT has this. The L is the same thing as this one, the IWOM L, EL, which I don't know what that means, if it means extra light or what, but it's a lighter weight suit, and it has a foot compartment, but it's not waterproof, and it doesn't have the amount of insulation that this one does. This is exactly what you need for some cold weather. So you're in your tree, let's say your feet get cold, like mine do. You're in your tree stand, just kick your feet out a little bit, get this foot compartment out. Get your feet situated in it so that it's flat on the bottom, which it does pretty quickly. And then there's a zipper right here. Another waterproof zipper with a nice pull tab on it, and it goes all the way around. All right, so now I'm fully contained. I mentioned this suit is waterproof. The other advantage that you have in a suit like this is that it's not necessarily scent control, but it's scent containment. So your scent is contained inside the suit, and so you know you can take field spray and stuff like that, spray down and do whatever. But this suit works really well for that. So I've got my hoodie. That's my hoodie hood. But here's the full face mask. Full face mask mode. For when it gets really, really cold. You got a mouth opening here. And there's this cinch strap on the back of this thing too, if you want to tighten this up around your head. And then your hood, rain hood. So you can see that this thing can withstand a lot of extreme weather, and you have the mobility that you don't have in other suits. So you have the ability to get out of this so you can hear what I'm saying. Draw your bow. You have full range of motion all the way around. You have enough room in here that you can actually move around in it a little bit. So on a tree stand, you have no problem in staying on the platform and changing your position to shoot. So it's a great deal. Now, when I'm getting out, sometimes it's cold enough to wear this in. So versatility is one of the key points to this suit. You can wear the fanny pack. Some of the other cold weather systems, you can't put them on and hike in them. Now in this suit, I can use a climbing stand, I can use a ladder stand, and I can have it on. So if I put it on the ground, I'm not going to obviously sit my feet in, and I want this up. So this is where this strap here comes into play. It's actually a waistband strap, so you hike up above your waist, And if you can see the strap, it's a cam buckle strap. I'm going to grab the cloth right here, and then I'm going to grab the inside the cam and slide the cloth. Get that up a little higher in the back. Slide the cloth along, holding the tension on the strap. And then you grab the other end. If you can find it, there it is. Pull the slack out. Take the last little bit there. Lock the cam lock. And there, you're in parka mode. So I can hunt like this, and I have, you know, the stalking hunt. I can wear this in. I still have full use of my arms. I can draw my bow. It doesn't bind me up like most layers would. So this is the IWOM XT to get out. You reverse the procedure. Obviously, you can put it on over your head. You can. I usually step into it. It's easier for me. So reverse order. Then to hike out, I just zip it up. Straighten her out. Roll the hood in, put my sleeves in, and then roll it up like a sleeping bag towards the feet. Tuck everything in the foot compartment. Get your stretchy pouch here, your spandex pouch. And there you go, you're ready to go to pack back out in fanny pack mode. One of the things that I didn't mention in here, there's a couple other cam buckle straps when you have the suit out right here on the sides, which allows you to basically just wear the suit on your legs and drop the top and tuck the slip. You take that belt basically, and it's about like this one. So they come out right here, and you can take your sleeves and the top and tuck them in and cinch that thing around them to hold it. So you can still stand up in it, and the suit stays around your waist. Hey, thanks for tuning in to this edition of iHunt TV's Tips, Tricks, and Gear Reviews. Hopefully you see how valuable the IWOM XT can be in extending your hunting season. So make sure you visit them at iwomouterwear.com. And give us a like on our Facebook page and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Be sure to ring that little bell so you're notified for new content that's coming out. Make sure you check out the other videos on this channel. And we hope that you have a blessed day and good hunting this season.